This is what that came to my mind as I was taking time with the Lord and praying. Who is actually a negotiator or an intercessor? I may use the word negotiator simply because of the context here in the book of Genesis, chapter 18, a very familiar passage which we have taken a couple of times, you know, in our different sessions. Even I remember I have taken this same passage in one of our fasting prayer session. So then only, you know, it began to see its importance we will be able to realize in a proper way. A good negotiator, a good intercessor, is a person who resolves the disputes or negotiates between the people so that they can come together. After the negotiation, the people will become one or at least come to an agreement. This is the purpose of negotiation. Sometimes some people, when they start negotiating, instead of coming together, they depart. That is not negotiation. That is not intercession. The real factor of negotiation is to bring the people together. And I know that some people are really very much gifted for it. Thank God that is not one of the 9 special gifts of the Holy Spirit as it is mentioned there, but it should be there in all the 9 gifts. Because of our relationship with God and because of our putting into practice what we have learned or God has given, we should be able to bring the people together, not make divisions and groups. That is not a negotiator. He is actually, or such person is actually, a damage to any church. But our responsibility is, even when the gap is so wide, stand at the two edges and hold the hands and bring them together so that the church of Jesus Christ may be one and it will be in the unity. What a great thing that God has given us through this, you know, passage in front of us. And we see that such a person is a great one in the sight of God. And I don't see many people in the Bible also doing those things in that way. But there is a person in the Bible who was a master negotiator. I'm not talking about God. A master negotiator in prayer. And his name is Abraham. So this is something that you all know. If we know what Abraham has done, let us try to practice that. Let us try to put it in our life. Instead of making, you know, the divisions or getting away from the people, let us bring together so that the unity of the church will be maintained. Let me also say that unity of the church is not in speaking tongues. It is not in making so much noise. Unity of the church is to be brought by the Holy Spirit, by bringing people together to the singleness of mind and attending unto the Lord Jesus Christ. He should be glorified, and through him we all can become one in the presence of God. So we understand that this passage is teaching us such a great thing. Besides being the father of our faith, and we know about Abraham, he was a great diplomat, a negotiator. And you remember that while he being in his earlier days, traveling from one place to another, going to, you know, Egypt, going to Gerar, going to Philistines' place, when he reaches there, the people, those who had been fighting for the well and the water, they have been brought together. And we see that his nature was not to create problems and make divisions, but rather to bring unity. It was God himself. That is one thing, you know, I wanted to say. Nobody else but God himself invited Abraham to negotiate on the table. God is the one invited. It's not that Abraham was going for a negotiation. If you read the passage, you will see that. And the way that God said about it, verse 17, it says, the Lord said, shall I hide from Abraham what I am about to do? It is an initiation that came from God himself. God wanted to have a man to come with him so that he can negotiate, to have an intercession in such a beautiful, penetrating way without having any coverings, but rather to have a very good heart so that the unity will be maintained in the proper way. Some of the negotiations are just coverings. Ultimate aim, they may have something in their heart not to bring them together, but God will never do that. God always do the things so that the unity is being maintained. Church of Jesus Christ, brothers and sisters, it is our responsibility to see that instead of dividing, instead of making disparity, instead of showing, you know, somebody important and somebody unimportant, always understand that the Church of Jesus Christ is a unity that has been maintained on the cross of Calvary, where he extended his hands at this time so that he can hold people from everywhere, bring towards to the cross. And that is what actually the symbolic expression of the cross of Jesus Christ. The Lord was looking at the extreme wickedness, as we all know, of Sodom and Gomorrah. And he was ready to judge these people. These two cities, God decided to really judge these cities, Sodom and Gomorrah. I don't know why he changed his mind. Is it because some people became so good? Nobody. They were exactly the same. They continued the same wickedness. But God somehow thought, shall I hide from Abraham what I am about to do? He has really decided what he is going to do. Why should he consult with Abraham? Time and again, dear my brothers and sisters, when God has decided certain things in his mind, he also remembered each one of us, and that is why he did not do that. He did not do it, and we are here today simply because he remembered us. Many of us don't remember every people. We have certain pockets to remember. We, you know, conveniently forget. But God is not like that. He is a God who remembers before he takes an action. Dear brothers, dear sisters, and some of these young people, when I see them, I just praise God simply because they were from such kind of families. They were not able to have this joy of salvation, but God remembered them also, and God brought them to Canada. God brought them to Scarborough. God brought them to the schools to study. But God is a God who also remembers that they should be having the fellowship with us. And that is why God has shown this place for them, and they come and worship the Lord. It was a joy for us to visit the house where they live. And I was amazed to see that 12 young men living in one place. And I thought that is the best place that we can have a Bible study. I told them, you know, that should be a place where we can have a Bible study. Only two people know Jesus. God is a God who remembers us. And that is why, you know, that verse has been there. Shall I hide from Abraham what I am about to do? So God remembers each one of us. And we know that these places were getting ready to be judged. But before sending the judgment, before sending the actual hails and the fire, God remembered Sodom and Gomorrah. I know that you will know it why Abraham is being brought into the scene. There is a nephew who is living there, and God could not even forget somebody who is serving God and his relative. Some of you are here simply because somebody else prayed for you, and that is the reason why we are here today. Maybe some of our fathers, brothers, our cousins, our people, those who were friends, they had been in the presence of God, interceding for you and me. You can see such a relationship between God and Abraham, because God cannot do certain things without remembering Abraham. He wanted to do certain thing, but all of a sudden there is a shock. He stopped and he remembered, I have to tell this thing to my servant Abraham. Brothers and sisters, and some of you, those who are interceding very much, I know that God remembers you, and he will surely do the things in relation to you and also in relationship of your family. He will not do certain things simply because you are an intercessor in the presence of God for your brothers, for your sisters, for the people, those who have come across. Somebody remembered to pray for me to see Jesus. And God is such a God that he cannot even bypass Abraham. Are you such a person that God cannot bypass you? If God has started or planned to start certain thing on your life, he is the one who wants to have that relationship with you. Please understand how beautiful is the Word of God. Your relationship with God is so important for God. And when you are shedding tears, he is not wasting his time, but he is looking at you and taking care of you. You are praying for somebody, he hears you, and you are gathering together to take all the needs. He is the one who is listening. Praise God. What actually made God to let Abraham know his decision, which is actually deserved for the people of Sodom? They were deserved it. It's not that God changed his mind because they all became good. They all far worse. Why wouldn't Abraham really carry over or applaud God's decision, rather than asking a change? He could have said, God, your decision is very good. They all are sinners. They should be really punished. But why, Abraham, that you wanted to intercede? One thing I already told, Lot is there, that may be one reason, but that is not the reason. That is only a simple thing that we can bring into, because he lived in one of the cities of Sodom. Abraham would want Lot and his family to be protected and delivered from the wrath, I understand. But if that is the case, Abraham could have really simply asked a request. God, save my nephew's family. That could have been enough. Sorry to say that, chalappo nammalokke aayirunnengil athre cheyyathullayirunnu. We are so much concentrated for ourselves. As I have told it earlier, in Malayalam there is a saying, പടപ്പുകാരൻ്റെ തടി എനിക്കും ഭാര്യയ്ക്കും മക്കൾക്കും. ഇറ്റ്സ് ഓൾ ഫിനിഷ്ഡ്. ബട്ട് ഏബ്രഹാം ഈസ് നോട്ട് ദറ്റ് കൈൻഡ് ഓഫ് എ പേഴ്സൺ. ഹി ഈസ് വെരി ഡിഫറെൻ്റ്. ഹി ഡിഡ് നോട്ട് സിംപ്ലി ആസ്ക് ഫോർ ദി സാൽവേഷൻ ഓഫ് ലോത്ത് ആൻഡ് ഹിസ് ഫാമിലി. ഇൻസ്റ്റെഡ് ഹിസ് ഹാർട്ട് ഓഫ് കമ്പാഷൻ cried out for two cities, not for two families, two cities. He didn't know there were any righteous people who would perish along with the wicked. He didn't want, if there is any righteous person, he didn't want, you know, anybody to perish. And you look at this verse, verse 22, you know, and 23. Verse 23, somebody can read, please. Verse 23. Yes, he started Abraham's negotiation of intercession. You can see that for Sodom and Gomorrah certainly qualifies him as one of the greatest prayer warrior, and the prayer was one of the most beautiful prayer ever the word of God has shown. He was a wonderful negotiator and at the same time a prayer warrior, and his prayer was one of the best prayers that you and I can follow. It is unusual because those things he can see interactive, and we get to hear that back and forth between him, God and him. How many times he said, if there are 40 people, God? Oh no. 35? No. 30? No. 20? No. If there is no 20 people, why should I really spare this place? God, Abraham asked, one more time I will ask. 10 people. You know what actually Abraham thought? Abraham thought that at least there will be 10 people in this city of Sodom, those who will be living for God. If that is the case, my nephew will be saved. At least he will be escaped. And the city also will be spared. But there were not even 10 people. So we should appeal to God's character, because our God is a very loving God. Some people think that, you know, he's always angry. That is sometimes our, you know, nature. But God is not angry. He is anger towards the sin and not towards the people. Even when a sinner is there, he is very passionate to the sinner, but only against the sin. Abraham appealed to God by acknowledging that he is a just God. That you can see here. And he said, went to the presence of God, and he simply began to intercede with God, knowing that God is a righteous God. At the same time, he is a merciful God. At the same time, he is a loving God. At the same time, he shows his passion towards the people. And at the same time, his compassion goes towards the people. He said, would you also destroy the righteous with the wicked? That is the question he asked. See, verse 23. Abraham aduthi ennu paranjathu, dushtanodu kude നീതിമാനെയും നീ സംഹരിക്കുമോ? ഇൻ അതർ വേർഡ്സ്, ഹി തോട്ട് ഇൻ ഹിസ് മൈൻഡ് ദാറ്റ് ഹിസ് നെഫ്യൂ അറ്റ്ലീസ്റ്റ് ഈസ് എ റൈച്ചസ് പേഴ്സൺ. മേ ബി ഹി ഈസ്, ഐ ഡു നോട്ട് നോ, ഐ കനോട്ട് ജഡ്ജ്. ബട്ട് വാട്ട് ഈസ് ഹാപ്പനിങ് ഇൻ ദാറ്റ് ഹോം, അറ്റ്ലീസ്റ്റ് വി ഹാവ് സം അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡിംഗ്. എനിവേ, ലെറ്റ് മീ നോട്ട് ഗോ ഇൻ ടു ദാറ്റ്. ദിസ് ഈസ് അവർ ഫസ്റ്റ് ലെസൺ ദാറ്റ് വി നീഡ് ടു അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ് ദാറ്റ് ഗാഡ്സ് ക്യാരക്ടർ മേക്സ് അസ് ടു ഗോ ടു ഹിം directly without any kinds of difficulties.
നിനക്ക് ദൈവത്തിൻ്റെ അടുക്ക ചെല്ലാൻ വേണ്ടി ആരുടെയും കാല് പിടിക്കേണ്ട കാര്യമില്ല, സ്തോത്ര അയച്ചു കിടേണ്ട കാര്യമില്ല. അതെ, ദൈവസന്നിധിയിൽ നിനക്ക് കടന്നു ചെല്ലുവാനുള്ളായിരിക്കുന്ന എല്ലാ അവകാശവും ദൈവം തന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്. സ്വർഗം അതിന് നിന്നെ പ്രാപ്തമാക്കി വച്ചിരിക്കുകയാണ്. Abraham really knew what kind of a God he is serving. Do we know that whom we are serving? Sometimes ചിലരുടെയൊക്കെ പ്രാർത്ഥന കേട്ട, കർത്താവേ അവനെ ഒരു പാഠം പഠിപ്പിക്കണേ, നിന്നെ ഒരു പാഠം പഠിപ്പിച്ചല്ലാതെ കർത്താവ് അടങ്ങത്തില്ല. Don't pray like that. Just see the goodness in people. Sometimes we get, you know, emotionally taken up in such a way and our vocabularies become so evil, even in prayer. If that is the case, none of us would have been here. Some people think that they are just people, very holy people. No, none of us are holy. The one who thinks so holy is somebody who is very sometimes secretly doing many things, all malpractices. But God is the one who knows us very well. The more we have intimate fellowship with the Lord, the more we know His qualities, His character and His nature, we will say that, Lord, how great you are. How great you are. We thought that you will be punishing us, but we know now that your mercy is enduring for us, and that is the reason why today we are here to worship in the KCA, a sanctuary. When we intercede on behalf of us or for our family or of our nation, we should likewise invite God's attention and proclaim. I wish that we should be praying for North Korea. I wish we should be praying for India. And we should be praying for places that are undergoing difficulties in other European countries. We can ask God to talk to them. Our proclamation or our intercession will surely work in the way that God wants us. All of heaven, you know, whenever we intercede, it's not that somebody who is with you hearing. All of heaven, including our God and all the angels and the people, those who are, you know, in eternity with the Lord, they all hear what we are praying. And they agree with us that the kingdom of darkness will tremble at that kind of prayers. And they know that they will lose the battle if a child of God stands. And the Bible says, Abraham drew near and said, will you indeed sweep away the righteous with the wicked? Suppose there are 50 righteous within the city. Will you then sweep away the place and not spare it for the 50 righteous who are in it? And the answer is no, he will not. We should call upon God's mercy, his patience, and his loving kindness, his greatness, and his faithfulness. And we do so. God is a God who honors us. He will surely. Our own faith level needs to raise a little bit more when we pray for somebody else. And we begin to expect God's very best that he will do in all the situation. Have a good mind. When you are sincerely praying for something for yourself, what a good mind we have. Let us also transplant that good mind when we are praying for others. The Bible says, you know, I have no much time to go through all those details. And when we come to 22 onwards, we know that things have been taken place. Verse 27, somebody can read. Praise the Lord. Yeah. Vaichu.
Okay, we know that passage, so I am just coming back to the same place. Second, you know, aspect I thought is that we should keep on pressing in certain situations when we are doing intercession. With one intercession, sometimes may not be, things happened in the way that, you know, really God wants to have it. So the second aspect that we can see is that keep, you know, really pressing to God. Keep interceding. Keep asking God. Abraham's second strategy was that he kept on pressing. He started off asking the Lord to spare the city if a few as 50 righteous could be found. God said, no, I will not. And we know that numbers coming up to 10. When it came to 10, he was a little bit fussy to ask God. If there are only 10 people, God so strongly said, I will not destroy it on account of the 10 people. It is not the big crowd what God is looking for. What God is looking for is a righteous person living according to God's standard and God's word. You can have thousands and thousands and millions of people, and there are churches with millions in India. Now, it's not the number that matters. For some people, number is a big thing, but for God, righteous people are the main thing. This exchange really shows that the heart of Abraham. അബ്രഹാമിൻ്റെ ഹൃദയവും കൂടെ നമുക്ക് കാണാൻ അവിടെ പറ്റൂ. 20 കൊണ്ട് നിർത്തി 15 ആക്കി എന്നാൽ ഇനി അവൻ പോകുന്ന പോട്ടൊന്നും കണ്ട ആരാന്നറിയത്തില്ലല്ലോ നീതിമാൻ, അതുകൊണ്ട് വിട്ടേക്കാവുന്നൊന്നും കരുതിയില്ല. 10 അത് എൻ്റെ ആ നെഫ്യൂ വരുമോ എന്നുള്ള ചിന്തയും കൂടെ അവൻ്റെ അകത്ത് കാണും. ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് നോട്ട് റിട്ടൺ ദയർ. ദ ഡിഗ്രി ടു വിച്ച് വി വിൽ പ്രസ് ഗോഡ് ഫോർ സംതിങ് വിൽ ഷുവർലി റിവീൽ വാട്ട് കൈൻഡ് ഓഫ് എ ഹാർട്ട് ദാറ്റ് വി ഹാവ്. Go to the last level, asking God to do something for that brother, that sister, someone who is to come to the Lord. Lord, help us, Jesus, to keep on knocking so that at least few, at least 2 or 3, at least 1. This morning, I got a text message when I entered into this place. It was from the man who gave us the ride in the Uber. I tell you, God can touch people. And any effort that you can do, something to bring somebody to the Lord Jesus Christ. And I know that there are some people in our church with the passion. They go to the downtowns. They go to the places where they can distribute tracts. And they preach in the downtown. Only the thing is that it's not proclaimed among us. People, those who are really searching for the souls. How much do we want God's will to be done upon our life? Remember that God wanted Abraham to negotiate for the city, and we know that. So you have that kind of a burden in your heart. Surely we can see the hand of the Lord working in a wonderful way. And let us come to the next, you know, come to verse 32. Praise the Lord. That is the third step that Abraham has taken. Standing in the gap. He was ready to stand in the gap, willing to be used God, you know, used of God to avert the judgment
that is on the cities. The Lord was again looking for the one like Father Abraham. After many years past this event, God was looking for people, whether I can find somebody like Abraham. And he was in search. And you go through the book of prophets, Isaiah, Jeremiah, and Ezekiel. You will see, when you are searching the word of God, you can see that God is searching for people. And when you come to the book of Ezekiel, as it has been said, 22 chapter verse 30, I sought for a man among them who should make the hedge and stand in the gap for me for the land, that I should not destroy it. But I found none. ജനം നശിച്ചു പോകാതിരിക്കേണ്ടതിന് ഇടിവിൽ നിൽക്കുവാൻ ഒരു പുരുഷനെ ഞാൻ അവരുടെ ഇടയിൽ അന്വേഷിച്ചു, പക്ഷേ കണ്ടില്ല താനും. ലോർഡ് വാസ് ലുക്കിംഗ് അഗെയിൻ ആൻഡ് അഗെയിൻ ഫോർ പീപ്പിൾ ദോസ് ഹു ക്യാൻ സ്റ്റാൻഡ് ഇൻ ദ ഗ്യാപ്. ഐ വിൽ ടെൽ യു മോർ ദാൻ എനി അതർ റെസ്പോൺസിബിലിറ്റി, വാട്ട് ഓൾ ദ പോർട്ട്ഫോളിയോ വി ഹോൾഡ്, സ്റ്റാൻഡിങ് ഇൻ ദ ഗ്യാപ്പ് ഈസ് ഫാർ ബെറ്റർ ദാൻ എനി ഓഫ് ദോസ് പോർട്ട്ഫോളിയോസ്. ഒരാത്മാവിന് വേണ്ടി കരയുന്ന ഒരു ദൈവ പൈതലിനേക്കാൾ ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻ്റ് അല്ല നമ്മൾ ആരും എന്നുള്ളതായിരിക്കുന്ന കാര്യം ഓർക്കണം. സിൻസിയർലി, എന്തെല്ലാം പദവികളുണ്ടെങ്കിലും എന്തെല്ലാം ചുമതലകളുണ്ടെങ്കിലും എന്തെല്ലാം പോർട്ട്ഫോളിയോ അത് ഏൽപ്പിച്ചു എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാലും, ഒരാത്മാവിന് വേണ്ടി നിലവിളിക്കുന്ന ദൈവ പൈതലിനെ ഓർത്ത് സന്തോഷിക്കുന്ന ഒരു ദൈവമാണ് നമ്മുടെ ദൈവം. Sad words came, I found none. Yes, God is on the lookout once more for great negotiations in our places where we are living, in the boroughs or the areas where we are in a dwelling. He is on search even today. Think about our friends or neighbors, those who are working with us in the factory or in the office. We may have a lot of things done for them, fine, but did you ever take a time to talk to them about Jesus Christ? You have entered with them with the party or the send off meetings. You had such times very good in your life, but did you ever think that I will take a moment to speak to the colleague who is working with me, who is studying with me, who is in friendship with me? This is not to be taught. This should be inculcated in us. While I'm studying in 9th standard, I went to my class teacher, Ramakrishna Pillai, and I talked about Jesus to him. When I say something from here, I know that things that only took place in my life, I say, it's not a testimony that is created by me. Say what you have in your heart about Jesus to somebody else. Think of the deserved judgment. Is there today in many of the cities across our country, or you know, US, or in Gulf, or in India, or other places? Now all are at the verge of doing something with the atomic things which they have prepared and waiting, so that the world can be one way or other destroyed before someone else also is being killed by the bomb shells. Try to share what we can with someone else. Yes, judgment is deserved for the world, I understand. But is that what God really wants to do? No, surely not. Before he pours his wrath upon the world, what if any one of you decided to tell someone about the good news of Jesus Christ? Would you proclaim the Lord's justice and beg for his mercy? Would you press it until you have secured the answer? There are certain people in relationship with you, friendship with you, and you are so nice and good for them. And they will be very happy until and unless you say about Jesus Christ, they have no problem. It's only when you share Jesus, some of them start getting away. It's only when you say the truth, some people don't like you. Don't worry about it. One day, we all will have to stand in front of our Lord. And there will be questions surely asked. And we will surely give an answer. But what answer we will give, let that be the judging point of your destiny. May the Lord bless us. Let us pray. Hallelujah, hallelujah. നമ്മെ കേൾപ്പിച്ച ദൈവിക വചനങ്ങൾക്കായി ദൈവത്തിന് സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യാം. Let us praise God and think for a moment. Think for a moment of silence. Ask the questions to ourselves. To the preacher, to the hearer, all are accountable. As we take this time to introspect our own life, I request Pastor George Thomas to pray and conclude with a word of benediction.